To conclude our session on women and political power, we are pleased to hear from our featured speaker, Liz Friedman. Liz first became a mother in 2002 and founded the Post Partum Support Initiative of MotherWoman in 2007. As Program Director of MotherWoman, Liz is a leading voice in advocating for fair policies for mothers, and with Annette Sycon, developed the MotherWoman Support Group model, which provides a safe forum for mothers to speak their truths. Liz serves on the Massachusetts Postpartum Depression Commission, is a co-investigator on research pertaining to postpartum depression, and in 2013 published a chapbook entitled, You Are Exactly the Right Mother. She joins the celebration of speech today to speak about her current advocacy for the Pregnant Workers Fairness Act in Massachusetts. It is my privilege to welcome Liz Friedman to the stage.
Good afternoon. Again, I'm Liz Friedman, and I'm the program director at MotherWoman, an organization committed to empowering and advocating for mothers, our partners, and families for 15 years. We are committed to not only ensuring that mothers have the support they need to do the important job of parenting, but that families have policies in place like equal pay, paid sick time, a living wage, and protection from pregnancy discrimination. We do this because, quite frankly, no matter how strong a mother is, if she is not standing on a solid foundation, then she and her family can fall through the huge cracks in the system. That's why we helped pass the earned paid sick time and minimum wage legislation in Massachusetts just this past year. And now we are working on addressing pregnancy discrimination. Today in the US, 50% of workers are female, and 75% of women will become pregnant during their working lives. 41% of women are primary breadwinners in families with children. And women are working later in their pregnancies. 88% of first-time mothers work while pregnant until their 8th and 9 months of pregnancy. Why? Because they have to provide a roof over their family's heads, food on the table, and health care. There really is a motherhood penalty. Listen to this. While single women under 35 make 96 cents on a man's dollar, married women with children make 74 cents on a man's dollar, and single women with children, they make 63 cents on a man's dollar. This is why the greatest indicator that a woman will live in poverty is becoming a mother. And this penalty for motherhood has the greatest impact on low-wage workers. Having a job during pregnancy is not an option. Women need to work through their pregnancies and know that they have a job to go back to after they give birth. If they don't, then they can experience a downward spiral into poverty that can be nearly impossible to climb out of. But what we find is that instead of having security in her job when she needs it the most, pregnant women are being fired from their jobs when they ask for reasonable accommodations. Reasonable, like a bathroom break, a bottle of water, an opportunity to sit. Mothers who work for minimum wage are the ones who experience pregnancy discrimination at its worst. And it's happening right here in Western Massachusetts. I'm going to tell you two stories about two moms just right here where we live. Sandy was pushed out of her job at the Holyoke Mall while pregnant. She didn't think it was safe to be climbing up on tall ladders, stocking shelves in her second trimester. Her boss said, "You have to." She needed to go to the bathroom, and her boss said, "No." So she stopped drinking water. And when she said, "I'm having sharp cramps and have to go see my OB," her boss simply said, "Go ahead, but don't come back," and fired her. Her family ended up on public assistance during her third trimester of pregnancy. Danielle of Westfield was pushed out of her job while pregnant. She worked at a gas station and was on her feet all day. Her back ached, sciatica burning down her legs, swollen feet. So she found two milk crates in the back room and sat down for a few minutes. Her boss said no. She was forced on unpaid leave and lost her health insurance 10 weeks before she gave birth. Getting pregnant in Massachusetts should not mean losing your job. As Representative Ellen Story says, we're not talking about letting a woman lie down all day. We're talking about pee breaks, a bottle of water, a stool to sit in, and not lifting heavy objects while climbing ladders. This is why MotherWoman is leading the statewide charge with Representative Ellen Story to pass the Massachusetts Pregnant Workers Fairness Act, so that no woman in the Commonwealth can be fired for asking for basic accommodations while pregnant when she needs stable income and security the most. Now, I know that everyone here either is a mother, has a mother, or knows a mother. So, I have something for you to do. I want you to ask the mothers in your life if they have ever experienced pregnancy discrimination, and then have them share their stories with us at MotherWoman. Because the best way to get a legislator to vote for the Pregnant Workers Fairness Act is to tell them our stories of the rampant discrimination that pregnant workers are experiencing. And together, we will end this era in which it is somehow okay to prevent a woman from peeing while pregnant, to make her climb ladders when she's in her third trimester, and to make her stand on her feet all day when it costs nearly nothing to give her a stool to sit on. Please join us in passing the Massachusetts Pregnant Workers Fairness Act, because mothers work hard for our money, and together we can make sure they are treated right in the Commonwealth.